They are beautiful and instantly recognizable, but also fragile and disappearing at an alarming rate. Today, the International Union for the Conservation of Nature added migrating monarch butterflies to its red list of threatened species for the first time and categorized it as endangered. A leading conservation group based here in Minnesota says everything from habitat destruction to global warming are threatening the beloved butterfly, but they tell me that now is not the time to lose hope. Monarch butterflies are hard to miss, but if you're wondering why so many are missing,
you see the egg on the leaf?
It helps to start at the beginning.
Do you see the ridges? That's how we can tell that it's an egg, right?
You see, it's easy to miss these tiny signs of life that cling to milkweed.
Do you see a lot of monarchs at our house?
Wendy Caldwell tries not to miss these little lessons with her kids.
Hold it.
Because searching for monarchs in all their stages.
What are you holding?
Caterpillar.
Helps them understand how vulnerable these insects are and how critical their habitat is to their survival.
He's such cute.
I got two caterpillars on my hand. He tickles.
Wendy isn't just monitoring milkweed with her kids. As executive director of the Monarch Joint Venture, she coordinates a national partnership of 120 organizations, including governments, universities, businesses, and nonprofits, all interested in conserving this now endangered butterfly.
We have dedicated volunteers all across the U.S. that are out there counting and trying to help us assess when and where monarchs are across the U.S. and Canada.
In labeling the migrating monarch as endangered, the International Union for Conservation of Nature cites a population decline anywhere from 22% to 72% in the last decade, depending on the measurement.
That is a very big gap. So why is it so difficult to even understand where the population is at?
Because it's challenging to really truly measure this insect that spans North America.
She points out there are two distinct monarch populations divided by the Rocky Mountains that migrate to different locations and have been impacted and counted differently.
Really, the best measurement we have for the monarch population is their status in central Mexico when they're overwintering, because they're in a much smaller geographic area.
But she says addressing population declines and staving off extinction will require national monitoring of more than just the butterflies.
We're flying drones over these vast grassland habitats to see if we can detect and count stems of common milkweed, to see if we can better capture what kind of monarch habitat is across the landscape.
How concerned are you that they might not be around for these kids when they're older?
I do think about that, and I get my kids out every day to explore nature. These are seed pods to gain that appreciation for it, and that's a lot of what we strive to do. Conservation relies on kind of continuous hope.
Put them back on the milkweed.
Yeah.
I remain optimistic that we're gaining momentum and increasing the desire for people to protect these charismatic species like the monarch butterfly.
And despite today's news, our federal government has not yet listed the monarch under the U.S. Endangered Species Act. Wendy says that when that happens in years to come, if it does, she would think it would be a good thing, prompting more funding for conservation efforts. In the meantime, she says everyone can take steps right now, from volunteering to planting habitat where you live. We've got a link to more information on care11.com.